Good morning. Good morning. This is Apostle Deanna Dixon. I pray that you are having a blessed day in the Lord. Oh, come on, somebody, give him glory, for he woke you up this morning. Oh, hallelujah to his name. If you see my title, this is a Thus Saith the Lord. The Lord woke me up this morning, and he woke all of us up. If you're up and you're reading this, or just sitting at home, or just on Facebook, or just is awakened. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. So basically, I want to start off with my scripture from Ezekiel 3:18, and it says, good morning, Linda. Good morning, Gaynell. Praise God. Good morning, Pop King. That's funny. Anyway, so let me get back to, all right, King James, Ezekiel 3:18. It says, when I say unto the wicked, thou shalt surely die, and thou givest him not warning, nor speakest to warn the wicked from his wicked way, to save his life. Come on, somebody. The same wicked man shall die in his iniquity, but his blood will I require at thy hand. Oh, come on, somebody. Hallelujah. That itself a preach all day long, because let's dissect that right quick. It says, when I say unto the wicked, all right, he's actually talking to them, thou shalt surely die. I mean, I don't think people understand the cost of sin. I think, you know, the world has camouflaged with everything with thou shalt not judge, and you can do what you want. And even Alex Crowley, I'm talking about that, thou do what thy will. Okay, everything has a cost. And it says, and thou givest him not warning. So that is that's also talking to the Christian. And thou givest him not warning, nor speakest. That means we're supposed to preach and teach and try to reach, nor speak is to warn the wicked from his wicked way, to save his life. The same man, the same wicked man, and when he says man in the Bible, he means also mean, he was talking about you, man, but he's talking about women and man. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. Shall die in his iniquity, but his blood will I require out of thy hand. Well, I don't know about you, but God did not save us for just ourselves. Come on, somebody. We have a message inside of us. That's why we were a mess. Come on, somebody. So when people are a mess, you're supposed to be the message. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Write that. You're supposed to not own. Christ was the message. Oh, come on, somebody. I could break this thing down so cold. Let me tell you something. Christ was the messenger, but he also was the message. Come on, somebody. And the crazy part is the Pharisees and Sadducees couldn't even see him. Didn't even know who he was, because guess what? Those that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. But I also want to talk about the thus said the Lord this morning that he gave me. So I'm going to actually read it again. It says, thus said the Lord thy God, return to me with a whole heart, then I will heal your land. Most of you are following the man of sin. Lawlessness has taken hold of this world. Remember Sodom and Gomorrah. That city was destroyed because of lawlessness, and they increased in wickedness. Do not become a victim of Satan. The enemy is after your soul, for he knows he has but a short time. So he wants to take you with him to his destiny, which is the pit of hell. Woe unto the inhabitants of the earth, for the devil walks among you, seeking whom he may devour, deceiving the people of this earth with lies and false promises, making them think that they will reign with him. But this is a lie, for he is the father of lies. Be careful, saith the Lord, for he has come to steal, kill, and destroy. He has released evil demons, and portals have been opened. That's why this world has become more wicked day by day. The devil wants to possess your body and then coerce you to do evil things, such as killing, stealing, raping, worshiping him. Repent, saith the Lord God, for the kingdom of God is at hand. Time is short, people. Jesus Christ returns, draw it near. Are you ready, saith the Lord? Stay strong, stay watchful, stay alert, stay obedient. For what will Jesus Christ find you doing on his return? That's a very good question, people. God forbid you should continue in sin, and that's all of us, me included. Count the cost, saith the Lord. This was the word of God, servant Apostle Deanna Dixon. So let me tell you something right now. I'm going to start actually doing lives on this, because for the YouTube family as well. But I'm going to tell you something. This one, it hit me, because you have to understand, I'm included too. Just because God gives me a message doesn't mean that it doesn't pertain to me. So let's talk about this thing. So God is saying that, remember Sodom and Gomorrah. Now, we all know the story that it was destroyed. And let me tell you how crazy it was. Even God had got Lot's family out of there. Let me tell you how seeds can still get you. They had left. They were leaving. And his wife, And God gave them specific, I'm sorry, to, oh Lord, I can't, I don't know why, you know how some words you have, but anyway, we're going to just skip that word all. God gave them directions. God gave them directions, and the directions was do not look back. Well, I'm going to tell you right now, she looked back and she became a pillar of salt. What are you looking back to when God told you not to? And look what happened. Now they were out of it. Isn't that uncanny? That's the same thing happens to us, especially as Christians and saints, believers. God will take us out of a situation. God will remove us from sin, allow us to beat that sin. And I tell you, it is a seed. I'm about to preach this thing this morning. I feel the power of God. It's a seed within a seed, God says. You know, like, have you ever bought something and have a seed and then you find another seed in it? You got to kill that inner seed. You see, the outer seed we can see is big and, you know, you can actually see that. But it's the seed that's inside. The Bible says that it's the small foxes. What I'm saying this morning is also the small seeds. You got to kill that seed. You got to say, God, take that out of me. God, kill it to the root of that thing. God, I don't want to practice that thing. God, I don't want to be like that thing. God, I don't want to do that thing. Whatever that thing is, which is sin. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. But I'm going to tell you right now, you can't beat the sin that you enjoy being in. You can't beat it. Oh, come on, somebody, hallelujah. And I don't care what anyone tells you. If your pastor, preacher, teacher is not convicting you every Sunday, I don't know why you're going there. Maybe because they find, or it's a big church, and y'all know what churches become these days. And I need y'all to know something. Nobody's bashing a church per se or the people. I just tell it like it is, meaning that if it's real, it's real. And most of this stuff is just real. People are not, they're not actually, if you put it this way, if you're not being restored, then I don't know why you're going to church. I'm just going to be real with you. It does not matter who you are, what church you go to. If the pastor and preacher, a teacher, apostle, whatever, whoever, is not restoring your life in every capacity. I'm not talking about just in the spirit, but physical, financial, every area of your life, we have to come in. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. This is, we don't get to enjoy sin. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. And if you do, the wages of sin is what? Death. We're talking about a spiritual death and then possibly a physical death. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. So if they're not convicting you, and I'm going to go here, and I know some of y'all going to say what you say, and I really don't care. One person I could never get into, and yeah, I call names because I ain't scared. I don't hate nobody. I need y'all to understand that, but I am a servant of God. I'm going to say it the way God tell me to say it. I could never get into Joel Osteen because, and listen to me. His messages are so watered down. Everybody going to heaven. Everybody love God. God love everybody. That's good. That's good. That's true. That's true, Joe. But tell me the truth. Come on, somebody. Ezekiel says it right here. Say unto the wicked. So we're commanded to, because every word of God is a commandment, whether you believe it or not. Thou shalt surely die. So you mean to tell me if I don't warn people that they should surely die? And then hold on. He says, but if you don't give them warning, his blood is on your hand. So am I the only one reading scripture here? Because the principles is the principles, meaning that we're supposed to warn people. Hey, you're going too far. Hey, you're in this sin. I didn't say condone people. I didn't say judge people to where you beat them down. I did not say that. My motto have always been and will always be love people back to life. Now, I'm going to tell you the truth. You can get mad if you want. And truth be told, if I'm in error, please tell me the truth. Because when a person really loves the Lord, you want the truth. Sometimes it's ugly. It's not pretty, but it's needful. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. So this is a very, very great subject that I pray that preachers and teachers start doing. Start preaching the word of God. Stop preaching your opinion. Stop. I see a lot of preachers, and I'm going here. Y'all have some great messages. I mean, I don't know. It's like you're, how could I say that? It's like you're a motivational speaker because you're really not applying biblical application. You're just preaching and getting everybody excited, and you're taking this and you're taking things of the world and you're putting it together. And it sounds good. I ain't gonna lie. Some of it sounds great, but that's good. But tell me the word of God. preach the word of God in season and out of season. We're commanded to, by the way. That's what it says in Timothy. Be in season and out of season. Meaning that, guess what? When they like you and when they don't like you. When you feel like it, when you don't feel like it. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. We have to tell people the truth. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. Because hell is getting enlarged, God says, day by day. And guess what? This word, why you think this world is so wickedness? There have been portals open and there have been possession of demons. Come on, somebody. God never, ever, ever. Let me tell you, this is going to be a subject I'm about to bring up. And some of you, this is a challenge question. Did God make everything? Now, before you say that, I need you to think. God saw everything in this world in those 6 days that he made it. And he rested the seventh day and they said, and it was good. There's a God of this world that have made some things. God never made bad things. I don't care what anybody says. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. Because he said, my Bible says, whatever he made in the 6 days, he said, it was good. Oh, come on, somebody, hallelujah. The God of this world wants to take everyone down with him. He knows he has but a short time. So right now, they are releasing demons. I'm talking about portals are being opened, which is spirits. Everything is spirits. I tell people, if you really want to know how a spirit works, and a lot of people don't like looking at this movie. As a matter of fact, I remember somebody in my class got really mad at me because I actually assigned them to look at the movie and she was so scared. And I mean, it started a whole mess. And here's the deal. If you're scared, you know why you're scared, right? I'm just going to call you out. You know why you're scared if you don't want to look at something. Nothing can hurt you. Especially, let me tell you what I do, because there are assignments that God tell me to look at movies and they have demons in them. I'm just going to be real with you. Well, y'all got to get over that, because I'm still trying to figure out how we got a church that's scared of demons. And yet that's all Jesus did. Most of his ministry was cast out demons. I'm still trying to wrap my head around that. How y'all scared of demons? But anyway, I digress. The movie is called Fallen by Denzel Washington. Man, when I saw that movie, that is the way it happens, by touch. And then the fool will talk to you and say and try to scare you. You see, I've had manifestations. A lot of people haven't met manifestations, so they don't understand. And I'll tell stories from time to time. I remember when I first got saved, and I really didn't know what I was doing. 27 years old, man in Louisiana, under Reverend Clovis Rogers. God rest his soul. And let me tell you something. One day I was driving in my car. I had just came for witnessing to a lady that was in the hospital. I worked in the hospital and God had told me she was going to die. He said, but I need you to go to her. And I had never met that lady a day in my life. And I was coming back and I didn't know where I was in Louisiana. It was a dark little town, small little town. And I'm telling you what happened. I was getting off of work one day and when I got in the, I felt something, you know, you can feel it. So I felt something. So I used to have this little Bible. So I pull out the Bible, right? And I started, you know, walking fast because you can feel when evil is wrong. I don't care what nobody say. Yes, you can. Now you can deny it and act like you don't, but I like to keep it real even with myself. So long story short, I got in the car and this is no exaggeration. I've had manifestations like this since 27 and I'm 51. Hello, talk to me. So anyway, I get in the car and I heard the angel of the Lord say, don't look in the passenger seat. And at this time, I was really, you know, I'm still something else. Don't get it twisted. But I was like, what you mean don't look in the passenger seat? And that night, I remember very, very, very good that the window, it was cold. So the windows was actually up. That window came down by itself and I heard, whew. And I'm telling you the truth before God, and I know some people are going to get scared, but it is what it is. I looked in the passenger seat, and I can't tell y'all what I saw. It looked like a gorgon. And that thing told me, die, be, die. Y'all know what the B word is. And I swerved, and I swerved, and I got on side of the road, and I'm going to be very transparent like I always am. I started crying. I did. I was scared as heck. I can't lie to y'all. That was my first time ever seeing whatever it was. It was a demon. And I said, God, wait a minute. You didn't tell me nothing about this. He said, Deanna. Now, and this is for you that ask and beg God to have spiritual sight. He said, Deanna, you can't have one without the other. I said, God, what are you saying? He said, you asked me and I told you I was going to give you spiritual sight. He said, can you think that you can see just the angels and not the demons? So once your spiritual sight is open, you actually see both sides. You see angels plus you see the demons. And I'm telling you, that was my first time ever seeing a demon. For 3 days, I ain't gonna lie to you, I was calling people and I was asking people questions. And I have to be honest with you, no one knew what I was talking about. So then I shut up because I said, okay, they're gonna think I'm crazy, so I'm gonna shut up. Because that was in 1996, so you gotta understand, people weren't talking about no demons. And I don't know if y'all remember, they had the little men in the little white coat come and get you real quick. So I shut up. I was like, okay, I'm gonna have to keep this to myself. But I was scared. I was scared, and I wanted to know. I said, God, and that's when God told me, he said, you're gonna get over this. You're gonna get through this, but you need to get closer to me, and you need to understand how to deal with these demons. So when I went to LA, I'm thinking, okay, whatever, just one time, it ain't gonna happen no more. I'm getting in the jacuzzi and I look in the tree and there's a whole demon again. I said, oh my God. So I was getting ready to run out the jacuzzi, and I never forget, God said, stop what you're running for. You have the power. And so I turned around, I looked at that thing, and I say, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, be gone. And ever since then, I ain't been scared of them. And yes, I still see them. I mean, even in the daytime, no, I ain't crazy. I don't take drugs. I don't take alcohol. I don't take nothing, baby. All I got is Jesus. But I also know that Jesus is the power. He says in Luke 10:19, he says, I have given you power over the enemy, all power. You see, I'm going to tell you what's going on in the church. We don't know our authority. We don't know our power. And that's because people are not talking about the manifestation of the power of God. The power of God is still here, you guys. Just because we haven't seen manifestations in a long time, and not everybody should take note to that. Why haven't we seen manifestations? Because the church is tainted. That's why. You and I both know it. So getting back to the subject at hand, it's a reason all these things are happening. That's why you have to walk in the power of God. And no, it's not easy. I'm not even getting rid here to tell you that it's easy. This is one of the hardest things you ever got to do in your life. But to be honest with you, nothing good comes hard, easy. I mean, let's just be real. I don't know. Some people like to try to go the other route. Sorry, you're going to come right back and you're going to have to do this. You're going to have to process. A lot of people don't want to process. A lot of people don't want to get in your word. Let me tell you something. It's the seven sons of Sceva. Y'all need to do a study on that. Dumb boys, they were casting out demons in Jesus' name. But they ran across, and you're going to run across some stubborn, heavy demons. Everything, different level, different devil. Them demons told them seven boys, he said, Jesus, Paul I know, and Jesus I know, but who are you? And they whipped them. They physically whipped them. They clothes off them. Do you understand what I'm saying? Because they didn't know their authority. They used the word of Jesus, the name of Jesus, but they didn't know the authority. You got to know your authority, that God has given you authority. But hold on, I'm about to catch y'all. You don't have authority if you're in sin. That's why it's so important to get rid of sin. And you talking to somebody that did everything. So I don't want to hear that, you know, judging or thinking I'm better. No. I know what it's like to be in sin. That's a process. Every day, to be honest with you, if you're a Christian, God keep me. Because we are in flesh, and flesh is a mess. You will have temptation almost 20, 30 times a day. Be real. You better start praying in tongues, do something. Because I promise you, if not, it will overtake you. Come on, somebody, hallelujah, which I rebuke in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. You got to learn to speak that word. Jesus combated them demons with the word of God. So if you know not the word of God, you cannot combat them. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. Praise God, praise God. So I pray that you are having a blessed day. Continue to walk in the Lord. Continue to walk in righteousness. Continue to walk in your authority. But you can't walk in authority if you don't know your authority. Get in your Bible. Read your Bible. Speak the word of God. Know who you are through God. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. And know, again, this is not easy, because I'm going to tell you right now, church folks then got lazy. The enemy then came in. I'm going to tell you how he came in before I leave. He came in through the entertainment industry. Music, y'all listen to music, even gospel music attained it. Y'all can say what y'all want. I ain't gonna get into it right now, but y'all know what time it is. Don't lie. Let me tell you what my grandma used to say. If it hits your feet before it hits your heart, it ain't gospel. I'm gonna say that again. Somebody write that in the comments. If it hits your feet before it hits your heart, it ain't gospel. Now y'all sitting up there playing games, whatever. So God bless you. God keep you. This is Apostle Deanna Dixon, Real Life Soldiers, for that is who we are. God bless.